In this tutorial, I'll tell you about how to use MS Word for reporting, and it will save you a lot of time and give your report a professional look. So I have to enter some type of data, title, how to use MS Word, and it contains main heading, introduction, tutorial on methods, results and discussion, and conclusion, references. These are the main headings. So I need to take them to separate pages. Introduction, so this is the title on the top of it. Title, you can define here is title, should centralize it, can change its formatting, but I'll keep the default font style. So in this is the heading one. Write introduction of your topic. This is an example of text. This is also heading two. Tutorial and methods are should be written here. This is just to mark the text under the respective headings. This is also heading one. Should bold it. Bold. This is bold. So keep the formatting uniform. Paste images and discuss them. Heading one. Explain your findings here. Okay, and keep your references here. The benefit of this whole exercise would be, you will see it in a minute. Introduction, this is, you can check where are the page breaks. These are used to bring your text to the next page. So I go to references, it is stuck, I think. I'll go to table of content. Okay, sure. So I don't need to define where are my headings. It has pasted the contents on its own. This is so because I have used the specific formatting heading style. So MS Word has come to know these are the headings. These should be pasted in the table of content. So I need to mention, I need to define the page numbers here. So you can see this should be introduction. Introduction is on third page. Okay. Material and methods are on fourth page. So this is the wonders of this. This is the facility you can avail. So you can also define, you can also construct a list of figures. Suppose I have a figure. Images. This is should crop it. Okay. Should crop it so that it is, it fits nicely to the page. Should reduce its size. Okay. It's in order to adjust into the page. I should go to insert caption. It is figure one caption. Define figure one title. Okay. So this is figure one. Okay, you can increase its font because it is 2, and can change it to from italics to normal. So this is on page 3. In other, I should paste another image. Insert picture. This is also too large to fit into the page. I should crop it first and then reduce its size so that it should fit nicely to the page. It should bring it onto the previous page because it belongs to the text that is present on previous page. So I should define insert caption. So you can see that the next caption, the figure 2 has come automatically because figure 1 has already been defined. So this figure numbering will be automatic. Define figure 2 caption. Here you can give any title, any caption, depends the figure you are defining. If we want our reader to see the list of figures on the first page, so we insert table of figures. Okay, so this is, so see, this has given us table of figures, and with the page number, with the respective figure number. So likewise, we can define list of table as well. Let me define its title, stuff table. So you need, figure one is in is on page number 3 and the page number on 3. If you change it, if you move it to the next page, so if you move it to the next page, Now it has come on the fourth page. You need to update it. You need to update it. Go to the references, insert table of figures, and this is the figures. Yes, sure. Figure 1, page number has been updated. Likewise, in table of content, you can also update it by clicking on update table. If you moved the headings or contents from the first or second page to the next page, if you have moved headings to other page, you should update it. So the table of content should have updated updated page number of respective headings. So let me show you how to insert table of you can define your table here, like it depends how many rows and columns you want to keep, and it should also its caption should also be defined. Insert caption, no label, it should be table. Table 1, this is the table 1. So, and you can define here, insert table 1 caption here, okay. So, as I told you earlier, we should keep the formatting uniform so that our report should look like look coherent. So, table 1 and table 2 on this on results and discussion, okay, to show you how to construct the table of content, list of tables, insert caption, table number 2, table 2 text here, title here rather, okay, label table, okay. Remember, so this is table 2 on, table 1 is on page number 3, and table 2 is on page number 6. So list of, where are the list of table? I have skipped it. List of table, okay. Similarly, you go to references, go to insert list table of figures. From here, caption label table, okay, not figure, table. So this will construct table 1 and 2, and table 1 is on 3 and table 2 is on 6. Okay, this is how you can make contents, list of figure, list of table, and generate them automatically. You don't need to increase them, you don't need to put them in manual form, so it will keep your report, your headings and respective page, and update it, provided that you update them after making changes. So one thing you need to you must have noted that the first page and the title page shouldn't have the page number, and this one should also shouldn't have the page number. The page number, if we want to start page number from introduction, page 1 from the introduction section, then we need to define some formatting here. We should double click on the header footer or header region. We should this is the, which is the next one, yes, we should put p page break, not page break, continuous break rather. Go to page, next page. This is the continuous page. Sorry, I have put in the wrong position. I need to give different page formatting to the first two pages, and I want to start page number one from introduction section. So I should define the continuous section here, because onward to this page the formatting would change. So the section break is should be defined here. So if when I double click on the footer region, so I should deactivate this button, because it will not carry the formatting of the previous pages onward. So here I should define the page number in Roman. Go to insert and page number. I should remove page number first. Look, page number have been removed from first two pages, but they are present onward because we are changing the formatting of first two pages. So first we need to format page number if we want to give them in Roman. So these are the Roman, and we are set this. Look, page number one, it's in Roman as you define in when you are doing thesis. The title and the introduction pages, the table of content, this acknowledgement, abstract, they bears the page number formatting as Roman number. The normal numbers are in should be from introduction onward. So I should, because this is the page number 3, and I should define that it should start from format page number should start at 1. So this is the introduction is started from page number 1, 2, 3, 4 onward. Okay, and the table of content sections is in Roman, true. Okay, one more thing I need to do is that I should remove this from the title page. Should click on this header footer and different first page. Yeah. So page number from the title page has been removed. So here your document is ready. The first page, how to use Word, MS Word. It doesn't bear any page number, and your content starts from Roman number 1. If it contains acknowledgement, delegation, abstract, then they will also be a Roman numbers. And then from introduction onward, your number would be from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So you should update your table if there are some changes. So they are, look, introduction has 1, 3, introduction page has been made from, as you can see that introduction is on page number 1, so it has updated your respective section. So list of figures, we should update them as well. List of figures, okay, replace. So it has also been updated. And then again, table, list of tables, read, yes. Oh. Table 1 is on page number 1. Page number 1, table 1 is on page number 1, so it is on, its page number has been updated. So, so this, in this way you can format your document, and that would be look, that will look for more, more professional. So if you want to look at it in an outlook, it in out as an outline, so this would be the read outline, yeah, this one. So this is hierarchy, this is showing the hierarchy of your headings. And look, this one, this is tag, this is introduction, you can, and this is plus sign showing a separate heading, and this is second, third. If you define subheading, they would come in this further in this hierarchy. Okay, so this is the outline, close outline. So it is, if you define subheading like introduction, if I say literature review, I need to define heading 2 because it is subheading of introduction 1. So I need to update table, insert, update entire tables to keep, look, this subheading has been added. So if you go to view, outline, so this is, this has been incorporated in the outline content, look, introduction, and this is subheading literature review. So in this way you can make your reports professional and easier to construct it and update it later. So I hope you have understood this tutorial, and if there are some ambiguities, some questions, you can post in comment section. Thank you very much.